Namaste, this is Nataraja Pillai. Today, we will have a discussion on hypersonic flight paths, right? So, in the previous classes, we had a discussion initially on, you know, how we can define the hypersonic flow. Say, at what velocity or what Mach number we can say that it is a hypersonic flow, and later what we have done is like it is not all about the Mach number, but if the flight experiences a certain phenomenon, then it can be a hypersonic flow or hypersonic flow. That is what our conclusion is, right? And then we had a discussion on the vehicles, how this vehicle looks like, right? Say how the hypersonic vehicle looks like, how the supersonic vehicle looks like, or how the subsonic vehicle looks like. That we had a discussion before. Now, later we had a discussion on the parameters, right? The various phenomenon involved in the hypersonic flow. So let me start the presentation today. Hypersonic and high temperature gas dynamics by John D. Anderson, I acknowledge. Right? So we had a discussion on various characteristics of hypersonic flow, starting from thin shock layer, right? Then entropy layer, then viscous interaction, then high temperature flows, right? So in the case of thin shock layer, we had a discussion on theta, beta, and M relation, right? And we understand that when there is a theta, beta, M, when theta is a deflection angle, which is constant, and the M infinity, if it is keep on increasing, then the beta also keep on decreasing, and hence the shock layer, that is the shock layer is the layer between theta and beta, is keep on decreasing, and hence the shock layer becomes so thin. Right, then comes the entropy layer, right? So in the entropy layer, we had a discussion on Kroskos principle, right? So Kroskos principle says that the change in entropy will lead to vorticity, right? That we had a discussion. Then we found that the interaction of vorticity, and we call this as vorticity interaction, right? Then we had a discussion on viscous interaction, right? The viscous layer, basically, the point from that is because of the high temperature, the necessary, the kinetic energy necessarily converted into internal energy, part of the internal energy converted into thermal energy. When the temperature increases, that in turn increases the thickness of the boundary layer. That thickness of the boundary layer, it interacts with the inviscid region, and that creates an interaction between viscous and the inviscous region. That is called viscous interaction. Okay. Then we had a discussion on high temperature flows, right? The vibrational excitation at high temperatures. Then comes the disassociation. Then at last, we have an ionization of the air molecules, right? The point is, like, we have some discussion and we understand that the temperature go up to 9,000, 10,000, 11,000 Kelvin, right? Then comes the low density flows, right? Low density, because of the higher altitude, the density decreases and hence low density. Also, we had a discussion at a very low density, the molecules mean free path is quite high, and we had a discussion on the Knudsen number, right? Knudsen number is defined as the ratio between the mean free path and the characteristic length, right? Then we had a discussion on molecular flow, right? Molecular flow. Then we had a discussion on equilibrium flow. And we had a discussion on equilibrium and non-equilibrium flow, right? So this is because of the chemical reaction, the rate of chemical reaction, and the velocity of the vehicle, right? Today our discussion is all about hypersonic flight paths, right? So we have studied all these phenomena, right? And the phenomenon occurs because of high temperature, entropy layer, and whatever it is. But fine, we need to fly a hypersonic vehicle, right? So if we want to run a hypersonic vehicle, we need to design a vehicle, and we need to design the of the vehicle, right? So here we will discuss about the hypersonic flight paths, and in the hypersonic flight paths, the two points which are really very important, and one is lifting and another one is non-lifting. So non-lifting will be called as ballistic parameter, right? And the lifting called as, you know, lifting parameter. Here we will discuss about how this lifting parameter and the ballistic parameter governs the flight path. So let us consider a flight, right, which is gliding, right? So this is a free stream velocity V infinity, and you know, in the direction you have a drag force, and here you have a lift force, and the weight is acting downwards, right? Now we know that based on say that this is a horizontal line, right? Now the flight path makes an angle theta, right? So we can solve this in the direction of the flight path and perpendicular to the flight path based on Newton's second law of motion, right? Rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the force. So the force acting on the vehicle L, lift force L, drag force D, and the weight W. We assume that the thrust force is zero, hence this is a gliding vehicle, right? So we can solve the equation, right? Here we can solve this, that right here in the horizontal direction, we can call this as not horizontal direction, right, in the flight path. So if you want to solve this in the flight path, you can write here as W cos theta, W sin theta. It becomes W sin theta. And in the direction of lift, we can write this as W cos theta. Right? So right. So we have, now we can solve this in the flight path and perpendicular to the flight path. So it becomes L minus W cos theta, that is equal to minus M V square by R, because we consider R as a local radius of curvature, right? So here we solve this as W sin theta minus the drag force, that is equated to M into dV by dt. So now we have solved it in x and y direction, I mean flight path and the perpendicular to the flight path. Then we can further reduce this equation by considering the theta value is so small, right? So sin theta is 0, cos theta is equal to 1. Sin theta becomes 0 and cos theta becomes 1. So we can write this equation as minus d is equal to m into dv by dt. And this m, we can write this m as w by g. So similarly, this equation becomes L, right, minus W, that is equal to M, this is M, W by G, right? So further we know that we have a information that drag can be defined in terms of drag is equal to half rho V square S CD, and then we can write this equation here, right? So half rho v square s cd is equal to w by g into dv by dt. So we can finally arrive to this particular equation, right? So this equation, we have the characteristics of this equation, right? W by CDS. So W by CDS is called the ballistic parameter, right? We will see how we use this ballistic parameter and lifting parameter. So for a purely ballistic entry, when there is no lift, this W by CDS becomes a governing parameter, right? Parameter which is governing the flight path, right? Again, here we can say that the lift is equal to half rho v square s, and then we solve this equation and finally we get, we have a term called W by CLS, right? So W by CLS is called the lifting parameter or lift parameter. So finally, the W by CDS and the W by CLS are the two important parameter. One is ballistic parameter and another one is lifting parameter, which determines the flight path through the atmosphere of the vehicle, right? Through the atmosphere of the vehicle returning from the space. So let us draw the flight path based on altitude and velocity diagram, right? So this is the altitude and velocity diagram, right? So here we can see that this is a lifting entry, right? Lifting entry case, we have the values given, right? Here, this is a ballistic entry, right? All these are ballistic entry by considering the CD as a component here, right? And this is the case given for space shuttle and Apollo re-entry, right? So WO is equal to CL by S corresponds to 100 pounds per feet square pertains to the space shuttle, where the W by CD is equal to 100 pounds per feet square corresponds to Apollo entry vehicle, right? So the idea is, like, you know, when as it flies deeper into the Earth's atmosphere, the vehicle slows as the result of aerodynamic drag, and it gives rise to the flight paths, right? So the larger the values of W by CLS or and W by CDS penetrate deeper into the Earth's atmosphere before it slows down, right? So that is the information we had today, and that's all for the today's discussion. We had a discussion on ballistic parameter W by CDS, and then the lifting parameter W by CLS, and we had a discussion on velocity altitude map, and had an example of space shuttle, right, and the Apollo re-entry. Right. So I stop at this point. Thank you very much for joining.